Now that we're working in the 3D piping environment and have switched to the 3D piping workspace, you'll notice the ribbon menu at the top with various features. And the tool palette is ready with our piping components. Let's quickly go over the key options available on the ribbon. First, we have the Project Manager. If you're using a smaller screen, like a laptop, and need more drawing space, you can minimize or close this window. If you need to bring it back later, simply click on Project Manager and it'll reappear. Now, let's open drawing 01_04_piping. Next is the Data Manager, which gives you a detailed view of the components in the drawing. If your drawing is empty, nothing will appear in this window. Always double-check that there are components in your drawing. Switching to Plant 3D allows you to see every component and piece of equipment in the project. The Parts Insertion panel is where you'll start piping runs. Here, you can set the line number, choose pipe sizes, and select the appropriate spec. We'll dive into more detail about running pipe later, but all the tools for piping setup are found in this panel. Once your routing is complete, and you want to create views or sections, use the ortho views to generate your orthographic views. The compass tool is crucial when running pipe. It lets you predetermine angles like 90 degree or 45 degree for accurate routing. Let me demonstrate. When you start a piping run, you'll see a red compass guiding the direction at set angles. You can customize these angles, turning off the snaps if needed, and specify custom angles as required. A compass tool can be toggled off if you prefer to run pipe without snap points. If you want to switch the compass to vertical or change directions, simply use Control, right-click. You'll see that the compass changes direction, allowing me to run the pipe vertically. Each time I click, you'll observe the compass adjusting its orientation again. By understanding how to use this compass effectively, will help you optimize pipe routing. Elevation and routing will allow you to set a fixed elevation for pipe runs, which we'll explore in more detail later. For projects involving slope piping, especially in industries like food, beverage, or pharmaceuticals, you can use the slope feature to define a rise and run. There are also options for pipe supports, accessible both from the ribbon and tool palette. You can even create custom supports, which we'll discuss in later lessons. When it comes to working with equipment, the Create Equipment feature opens a dialog box where you can create custom equipment shapes using parametrics. Visibility tools help manage what's visible in the 3D environment, which makes navigating complex models easier. Other sections, like View and Layers, are standard AutoCAD functions. At the top, you'll find an ISO tab for running isometric drawings and the Structural tab for working with structural steel components. It's a good idea to familiarize yourself with these tools and panels, as we'll be using them throughout the course to build our model. Take some time to review where everything is located so you're comfortable before we dive into more complex tasks.